timekeeper.
Hi guys, I'm Abby. So I just want to start off by asking, like, just by raising your hand, how many of you guys have ever had chicken pox, whether you were a baby or a kid? So for those of you who have had chicken pox before, every single one of you are susceptible to getting shingles. So some of you might know what shingles is, whether a relative has had it, or if you guys have seen the commercials on TV or anything like that. Some of you might have not. So what shingles is it's basically a disease that you usually get when you're later in life. And it's a viral infection that causes a rash. And this rash can be anywhere on your body or even on your face. So the scientific name for it is varicella zoster, and it's the same exact disease that you get whenever you get chickenpox. So the first signs that you get when you think that you might have it is you will feel a tingling or a numbness or a burning sensation in your skin. What it does is it affects the nerve roots in your body, which causes that burning sensation and everything like that. So most of you might know that having chickenpox is contagious. So in order for you to get shingles, is you have to have chickenpox before, and you can only get it by having direct contact with the rash that you might get. So what this is the rash will go and turn into these blisters. These blisters will bubble up and they can erupt and ooze, and it's disgusting. So if you've ever cut yourself on your body or whatever, you'll get a scab, and that's exactly what the rash will do. You'll get you'll get the rash, then you get the blisters, and then you'll scab over, and that's basically your healing process. So there's no exact way that you can cure shingles, but they are working on different things, which I'll get to later. So as soon as you're diagnosed from your doctor, you want to make sure you get medicine in you within 72 hours, just because the quicker that you get medicine into your system, the quicker that your healing process will continue and get better. So
these are some pictures.
So that shingle is on a man's shoulder. That's just a mild case of mine. And then, these are those are the blisters that it can cause, and then that's on a man's chest. So just to get that out of your way. There was a vaccine for chickenpox, and that was developed in 1995. Excuse me. And so those of you who are older than that age might not have gotten the chickenpox vaccination. And there's 200,000 cases per year in the U.S. of shingles that people have had. The reason why I'm telling you about shingles is because I was infected by the disease last year, which was my senior year. I thought it was just hives, and I thought it was just something that you randomly got, and I didn't say anything to anyone. And so I went to my nurse, my school nurse, and as soon as she looked at my shoulder, she dropped everything. She started wiping down, disinfecting the entire room. She put on a mask and everything, and I was just like, what the hell? Like, what is wrong with me? So then she kind of reassured me. She called my mom. She told my mom about it. My mom's like, what do you mean Abby has shingles? Like, isn't that for, like, older people? Like, how the hell does an 18-year-old get it? So my mom was, hysterical, and she didn't know what it was. So I really wanted to tell you guys about it, just because as the years are getting going by, there's only a vaccination for shingles, and you can only be 60 years old. That was in 2006. Well, in 2011, they had another vaccine that you can get, and you can be 50 years old. So as time goes on, younger people are beginning to get this disease. So this is why I wanted to inform you guys, because anyone, whoever raised your hand for having chicken pox, you guys could eventually get it, or know a loved one that could get it.